just like everyone else. No one tells you that. That when she holds an object, she tries to imagine who owned it, who made it, everything it had experienced. Where your sisters came from, they beg you to tell their stories. Which they seem to want to collect, where it's charmed. Nobody could touch her story. Of course, she kept them mostly hidden. So her sisters did not try to fake. She was free, like a child without anything to worry about. Like it is before you're seen, and then again after you can never remember who you were until someone showed it to you. Your stories made your sister love. Or at least me. You cannot hide forever. I have seen the things you create, the stories you read. You are the one who creates, who transforms. You need to dress yourself up for once. Put on the dress and the shoes made of your words, and enchant those around you. Make yourself feel something more. But be careful. Because those shoes are made for dancing, not regular. They were all drawn to her. They became enchanted by the stories they told. For they saw the stories of themselves. She knew they felt those ways. Because she became them, they became her. Painted her. Her beauty, her wisdom, her fragility, and then he turns. Her sister's eyes are jealous and secret. They had stories too that they'd like to tell. They'd like to make someone feel, cry, and swoon in the center of love.
How dare she stay out at night? Who is she to take the stories away? She's not as beautiful as us.
She just rearranges the stories we've always known.
How can anyone think she's special?
How could we ever think she was special?
Last, newer sister stuff. She stopped telling stories. They stopped making sense inside her head. And the words that came out of her mouth were ugly. Not heard or seen. She was what every girl becomes when they no longer feel loved by the hearts of the sisters who did not meant to break, but did. Fear sets in. She began to wonder, can't she be safe without the sisters?
It doesn't matter. The sisters, they don't hate me. No one will hate me. And no one will hear me. And no one will hurt me by leaving. I can't live a fairy tale forever.
She built up her walls to lock out the stories. But still, he came to her. He came to find her without her enchantments, her dress, her shoes, and her stories. Her sisters saw how he needed her. And they thought that if they tried to take this away, he would starve and break, and never wake up. We all want what they have. And to achieve it, you must look deep inside yourself, where stories live. Not young, not old, not ugly, not perfect. Crying your own way and laughing at your own sorrow. You must find what was always there.